Good morning, students. I am finished exercise 1.1. In exercise 1.1, totally there are 10 sums. I have derived all the 10 sums. Now, there are few sums in examples. Nearly, I think so, 9 sums, not few sums, totally 9 sums in this example. In first sum, first example sum, I have given as a homework sum. 80% of students submitted, only few, nearly 8 students are not submitted the homework, but no problem. In coming days, students all need to submit your homework sums properly. Now I am going to move towards example 1.2. This example 1.2 is a different sum, but don't need to worry. I am going to teach you the example 1.2. See, first, we need to read the question for this. In a survey, has 5,000 persons in a town. Totally, how many persons are in the town? 5,000 people. 5,000 persons are in a town. It was found that 45% of persons knows language A. So, total person. First, I write the total person. Total person is nothing but 5,000. Students, it is better to open your textbook also when you are doing the sum, so it is very useful for you. Next, it was found that 45% of persons know language A. How many percent? Nothing but 45% of persons know language A. Next, 25% know language B. Language B is nothing but 25%. Next, 10% know language C. Language C is equal to 10%. 5% know language A and B. 5% know language A and B. 5% knows language A and B. Next. See, after 5% knows language A and B, 4% knows language B and C. 4% knows language B and C. 4% knows language A and C. 4% knows language A and C. And 3% knows all the three languages. 3% knows all the three languages. All the three languages is nothing but A, B and C. All the three languages nothing but A, B and C. What is the question we need to study properly? Find the number of persons who knows only language A. I need to find the person who knows only language A. They given two methods. One is the formula based method and another is Venn diagram. I think the Venn diagram is very, very easy when compared to the formula method. Because in 9th standard you will study the Venn diagram. I am once again teach you what is a Venn diagram. See, there is three languages. So A, B and C. This is only the rough column. Language A, B and C. Only A means this is the only A. This part alone only A. Only B means this part alone only B. Suppose this is A and B and C. This part is only A. You are studying 9th standard, I think so. Correct? Yes, exactly. The first term in 9th standard. This part is only A. This part is only B. And this part is only C. So, what is this part? This part is nothing but A intersection B. You want to take full part, A intersection B. Listen nicely. This is B intersection C. This part is A intersection C, or you can say A intersection C or C intersection. This part is A intersection C. What is the this point? This part is nothing but A intersection B intersection C. All the common things I put this one. A intersection B intersection C. So, using the Venn diagram, I'm going to solve this sum. Very easy sum if you're going to understand. I'm not having any bangles or not. I'm not having any compass. So, using the free hand, I'm going to draw the diagram. But if you have any scale, you want to draw the Venn diagram using only on pencil. So, use the pencil and please draw the diagram. First, I will draw the diagram. I have drawn that three diagram. Why I draw the diagram? This is a language A, this is language B, this is language C. Language A and B and C I have drawn. First, I need to admit all the three languages, admit. A, B, and C, nothing but three. Three. Sir, they are given 3%. Why are you not choosing 3%? Because all are percentage only. Better I will use the 3 as percentage itself. We don't need to indicate. I will put 3. I will get 3. See, after that, I want to indicate A and B. This one is A intersection B. A and B is nothing but A intersection B. This part fully, what is this part fully? A intersection B. What is A intersection B? What is A and B? 5%. Because I need to put 5%. Already what is present here? 3. So 5 minus 3 is nothing but 2. I need to put 2. How you are putting 2, sir? Very, very easy. See, this A intersection B. What is A intersection B? A intersection B is nothing but 5%. But already here, what is present here? 3. So 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. So 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Next, I put 2 here. If I want, I will put here. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Next, I am going to see A intersection C. A intersection A, C intersection A, whatever C. A and C. A and C, no. A and C is 4%. If A and C is 4%, that is already 3 is present here. So 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. 1. It's over, sir. Not over. I am not doing this one. I am going to choose A. What is A here? 45%. What is A? This whole circle is 45. This whole circle is 45. In whole circle 45, what are present? 2. 3 and 1. 1 plus 3, 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. But what is the present here? 45. So I want to choose this only. So 45 minus 6. 45 minus 6 is nothing but 39. I need to put 39 here. So this is only A. This is only A. How many A? 39 are present. I think I scribbled 39. Sorry. 39. This is 39. But in question, all given percentage, this is a percentage, this is a percentage, this is a percent, this is also percentage. But they are asking numbers of persons, they are asking number of persons, so I want to convert the percentage into numbers. Therefore, for this number of persons, only A alone, nothing but 39%, I can write 39 by 100. Total, how many is present here? 5,000 persons. Two zeros cancel. So, 95, I will leave 0, I will multiply 0 afterwards. 9 5s are 45, 5 carry your 4. 3 5s are 15, 15 plus 4 is 19. Now put 0. So, how many persons knows only A language? A language. How many persons knows only language A? I would like only A, I put language. Language only is 1950. This is one type of question. They asked only A, I have found only A. So, I not entered B and C. Suppose sometimes the question may ask only B. If only B means I want to choose only B alone. 2, 3, I want to fill this one. I want to choose this one. Lastly, I want to find the answer. What are the question you need to write? Only A means only A. Only B means only B. Only C means only C. Sometimes in public sum, in public question paper or any other sum, they will ask as a creative question only A. Only B, only C, you don't need to worry. If you understand the concept of this sum is very, very easy for you. So now I finished and solved this sum. I think that I made you to understand this sum. I made you to understand all this sum. So do the sum properly and study the sum properly. Thank you.